Hello, good afternoon. It's 2 o'clock. We are welcome you to our webinar this afternoon. I will, of course, wait a few minutes to allow people who are a bit late to join us. We are using a new tool to organize this webinar, so I hope you won't have any problem with your connection. Okay, so I gave 1 minute to the people who are late, so I will consider that's enough. So good afternoon again. So I'm very happy to be with you this afternoon. So before we start, I will give you some practical information on the course of this webinar. So we will have around 45 minutes presentation followed by 15 minutes of questions. As you can see, you can ask a question using the chat on your right, ask a question. Fabrice Tufigo will be our moderator today. And Florence and myself will be happy to answer your question then at the end of the presentation. There will, of course, be a replay of this webinar, and all the participants will receive the PowerPoint. So we will start by this webinar, and I'm happy to introduce you Florence Beke-Abdou. I'm not sure there is a need to introduce Florence. She's very well known, very active. Particularly with the Cercle Magellan, for example, and she's a lawyer working for PwC. So welcome, Florence, and thank you for your support today.
Welcome.
And I'm Laurent Cochet. I'm the Deputy Executive Director of MSH International. So I will leave it to Florence first. We will probably do the first 25 minutes of this webinar. Thank you, everyone, again for joining us this afternoon. Up to you, Florence.
Hello, everybody. I'm really happy to discuss with you. We present the responsibility and the new social responsibility of company towards their international mobile employees. And principally, at this stage, I present the obligation and the French law obligation in this case, outside the pandemic situation. As you can see, the obligations that I will present are not new, but with the COVID pandemic, employees are much more careful and vigilant regarding this case. And we noted several refusal of certain countries because the employee consider it's too risky. It is therefore important that the company respects the following four basic obligations. The first obligation is to inform clearly each employee before their departure of the risk they may be faced abroad and any potential impact of their mobility on their social protection coverage. For each obligation, we describe after more detail. The second requirement is to ensure the health and safety of the employee abroad. It could be an evidence, but we see that it's more complicated. The third obligation is to repatriate and redeploy employees or their return to the country of origin, of the home country. Please note that it's clearly a French labor obligation determined by the French code. And the last general obligation is not really an obligation, but it's our recommendation, is to be sure we have no loss of entitlement at the end of the period international mobility, including and specifically pension entitlement, because we see a lot of discussion and revendication before the French court. For the first obligation, the requirement to inform employees before their departure of the risk they may face abroad. It is clearly an obligation for the employer to take a necessary measure to ensure the safety and protect the physical and mental health of the employee. It is normal, it's not a specific obligation out abroad, it's an obligation in France. But regarding the context, it's really necessary to check that each employer have an obligation to identify and to take action to prevent occupational risk and difficulty working condition. Information and training, it's really a necessity to organize a training for the employee if regarding the specific risk or specific country, the implementation of appropriate arrangements and means. We see after the reference in French law and European directive. Clearly, this obligation concerns the expatriate people from France to outside, to abroad, and expatriate people in France or a member state in Europe, because it's clearly an obligation that each foreign employer should be respect this health and safety of workers in Europe. The second point is to be sure, and it is an obligation for the employer, to verify that these measures are revised depending the circumstances. And clearly, with the COVID, all employers discover by moment that they have a really pressure of the employee regarding this risk and this new risk. And in final, it's necessary for the employer to must avoid risk, assess unavoidable risk, and combat risk at source. Clearly, if the employer consider and is the security or surety our team in the company consider that the country is too risky, is not correct to send people, to transfer people in this country, normally this country should be not, no mobility should be not realized in this country during the temporary time, during this specific period. And that's why during the pandemic situation, before and after, because it's clearly an off classic obligation, it's really necessary. It's really, really an obligation to check the risk for the employee when you send people abroad and in this country to verify this risk and the level of risk to be sure it is possible or not to transfer people. And if it's not, it perhaps necessary to check perhaps another transfer, perhaps a virtual assignment, for example, or perhaps to modify the mobility to mobility scheme. The second obligation is to, regarding it's clearly to give all information of your employee regarding their social protection coverage. In this obligation, in France, clearly, the employer has this obligation to inform all employees, not only the international mobility employees, but including the local employee for all social protection coverage regarding their benefits. When we have the mobility, it's necessary to check before their departure and during their expatriation, what is your organization? What is this coverage? What are the health plan, for example? What is the provident fund to be active during this period? And that it's really important, notably when we decide to localize an employee. Because in this case, when you sign a transfer agreement, it is necessary that this employee should be totally informed to his future situation for social security and social protection coverage because it could be lost a lot and it's necessary to organize this new situation. For expatriates or assignees, they must provide clear and comprehensive information to assess the extent of their social coverage, protection coverage, and including if it is possible to include or to realize a voluntary social coverage for the French people, for example, by example, the CFE or by the unemployment insurance. Please note that in France, when we have a French employment contract and you expatriate people outside Europe, the French employer should be continue to contribute to the unemployment insurance plan. It is a mandatory obligation. And for all this regarding the whole package of the social protection coverage, it's really important that the employer could be proved that the okay of the employee, because it's really necessary to prove they have met this obligation, and that is really really important if we have the accident for the future, for example, to can prove that the employee knows the organization and receive all clear information regarding the coverage of each risk in this health, notably in health insurance. For the next. Yeah, and it is really important when the employee are exposed to the dangerous situation, because it may be a risk of aggression, racist, kidnapping, and other things for these people. And in this case, the employee should have an obligation to ensure the health and safety of the employee, particularly if the employee is in the danger zone. As I explained just before, it's a really important case in France. For example, when a company refuses to repatriate or refuse to find a solution to protect its employee, the risk is to pay a large damage and to be considered as a guilty of gross negligence from the French social security authorities. Why? Because if we imagine that it's a danger zone and the employee has an accident, it's considered automatically as a working accident. And if in this case, the working accident should be limited because the employer could be take a security measure in addition of safety of the safety and health classic measure, in this case, the French authorities could be considered that all of cost regarding this accident should be supported by the company and not by the government and by the French mandatory scheme. To give you an example, we have a recent court decision to give you an example. We have an employee in Ivory Coast who herself in danger, and she wrote to this employer, and the French company did not repatriate her and refused to take a specific measure. After 3 weeks, she was injured and obtained more 13,000 euros in damage in court in France. because in fact, the French authorities and the French court consider that these accidents that endure should be limited if the measure and the safety measure would be realized by the company. That's why this obligation to ensure the health and safety of the employee abroad, it's really a very, very important obligation for each employer in the international mobility scheme. We give you an example of different case of risk. You can, because we have the list in the presentation. And we give you a type of risk face the international mobile employees. Health risk, it's classic infection disease, as you identify, and depending the COVID, it's a classic situation. Epidemic situation, poor quality of local medical facilities or difficulty accessing medicine, for example. Please note that it's a really, really a point to be checked before to organize a transfer, because often the people refuse to accept the transfer, notably for their family, because the poor quality of local medical facilities, for example, or the difficulty to obtain a medicament or something should be really a blockage to realize a good international mobility transfer. And as I explained just before, security risk, by crime, hostage, terrorism, land and sea piracy, mines, other risks linked in the political and social environment. Clearly, normally, for each big group now, the safety and the security teams determine a list of authorized or no authorized country to be organized the transfer or to be organized the business travel only, and to accept or not the possibility to travel for their employee. And this list is modified each month depending the political or social climate, and now including the difficulty to be travel with the COVID situation. The third obligation is a requirement to repatriate employees on their return to the country of origin. Clearly, this obligation is a specificity in France, because we have no this obligation for different countries. This obligation is provided by the Labor Code. An employer who sends an employee to work in the subsidiary abroad under the French employment contract or the local employment contract must organize for them to be repatriated if the employment contract with this subsidiary is terminated. In this case, this employer must also offer them a new equivalent role in the French company or another company in the group. To organize this repatriation, the expatriate addendum or the secondment addendum in France, often we have a specific article drafted in the employment contract to organize the condition and the modalities of this repatriation obligation. Because it's really complicated to organize notably the articulation with the notice period in the local employment contract, if it's applicable, the notice period to stop the activity in the host country, and to notably to organize, for example, to the moving, to organize the tax quitus or something. And to organize by moment the business, because you could discover, for example, we terminate the employment contract is terminated with a subsidiary or the local host company in the group. But in fact, the French company needs to maintain this employee locally because it's necessary to close a business, to close a project. And in this case, it's really necessary to organize this end of mission independent the repatriation obligation. That's why normally we find in French law, in French employment contract, often all article regarding this case. Thus, it is important to see that this obligation exists and depending the maintained French employment contract. If the transfer of the mother company in France to the subsidiary in the host country, it's realized, and if the employee receive only a local host employment contract, this obligation of repatriation continue to exist, and depending the existence of the relationship labor law between the mother company and this employee could revendicate all time if the subsidiary, for example, decide because we have the pandemic situation or difficult situation, an economic dismissal. In this case, the employee could be revendicated anytime this repatriation obligation in France in the mother company. That's why it's really important to check this point, because and depending the form of the transfer and depending the organization of the employment contract during this mission or during the transfer, or if it is permanent because we have a localization, this obligation continue to exist for the French mother company in France. And finally, the obligation connecting with the repatriation, it's the last classic obligation, is to redeploy the employee within the group. Why it is connecting? Because when you have an obligation to repatriate people in France, it's necessary for the employer to find a new job for this employee. It is practical. Based the position of the court, is the employer must make the employee a genuine, specific, and compatible offer of reintegration equivalent to the job he had before he went abroad. What is this position? What is the illustration? It is not an obligation to give the same job of the employee when he come back in France. For example, during the transfer, this employee is the CFO of your company, for the host company. And when he come back, we have no function of CFO in France, perhaps another country or another company, or perhaps it's not the CFO, but perhaps it's more an administrative or financial position. In this case, it could be possible to propose this position, but the employee should be refused. And we have a specific obligation is to respect the last level of remuneration of your employee. If it is case, Fabrice, we see Word.
Oh, sorry.
And in this case, it's the specific and compatible offer. It's clearly not to respect the level of the job, but to have an obligation to respect the level of last remuneration before the departure, notably the base remuneration. And after, this new position must be expressly accepted by the employee. But clearly, it's not an obligation, that's why automatically the same function. But the difficulty for the French company, it's often without possibility to find a new function or a new job in the group, often you should manage a dismissal of this employee and to terminate the relationship with this employee. That's why this case, it's often really expensive for the company because it's necessary to respect the French procedure and to pay the different severance indemnity in this case. If we find a job, in this case, the new employment contract, a new documentation should be applied. And if the company refuses to redeploy the employee, refuses to give any solution, clearly we have two options. She respects the dismissal procedure, and in this case, they have a big risk without discussion and negotiation with the employee to be that the court considers the dismissal without real and serious cause. Why? Because in fact, the employee never come back in France to work. And in this case, to have no this availability function or ability ability job is not automatically in France a good motivation to dismiss a person. The second point is could be the demonstration that the employer refused to find a solution for the employee, and consequently, the employee could be revendicate this dismissal without real and serious cause in fact, and receives the remuneration by the court and to obtain the damage, notably in this case. At this stage, I explain the global situation. And the last case, it's clearly a new risk to be taken into account concern retirement. Why we indicate this obligation? It's not really an obligation, but by experience, it is very important to check that the pension contribution base comply with the French obligation of the company. This base obligation should be fixed by the collective bargaining agreement applicable in France or by your international policy applicable during the transfer. And clearly, why it is really important? Because now an expatriate could be revendicated long time after this transfer a damage and obtain a compensation before the French court regarding the no compliance from the payment of contribution. For example, a company refused to continue to pay the pension, but in fact, the French employment contract should be not terminated. In this case, based on the collective bargaining agreement, the company should be continue to contribute to this pension plan, voluntary pension plan, and perhaps or mandatory pension plan, it depends the case. The second point, it's really when you localize people, because a lot of discussion should be in this case. The employer must provide the employee with full information of their pension entitlement in writing and obtain the receipt from them, notably when we stop all social contribution in the pension plan in France. Because if we stop the supplementary pension, the state pension, complementary pension, supplementary pension scheme, it is possible when you localize the people without application of the French law for the future, it is correct to stop. But it's really important that the employer could be proved that the agreement, the total information in first by for the employee, and the second point to prove that the employee understand clearly he not receive for the future any pension, any benefits because the contribution should be stopped, should be ended, and it is necessary to check or to find perhaps a new solution. Notably in France, it is possible to continue to contribute by the voluntary scheme or to decide to propose an international pension plan, for example. But without that information, we have the big risk for the future that when the employee decides to liquidate his pension in France, he discovers this period where he loses a lot, and in this case, he could be received as a big damage directly to claim this situation before the court. That's why for me, it's really the future risk for the company, because in France, we have notably different cases with a really, really big amount decided by the court decision against the company. Laurent, you can see after the future.
Thank you, Florence. Thank you very much. Yes, in the second part of the webinar, we will discuss a new social responsibility of employers. It's responsibility, but it's also advice we would like to give you following this 1 year plus crisis. So we all agree that international mobility is key for the development of your business. Our former webinar shows that all of you really consider that international mobility is a key element of the success of your business. So therefore, following this crisis, there is probably lessons to learn and six things to put in place in order to make sure that you will be able in the future to organize international mobility despite potential crisis such as the one we are still facing. So it's responsibility, and also we will present you. Florence mentioned the virtual assignment. We also know that this is a nice concept, but at the end of the day, it's by being on the ground, knowing the culture of the country, being with the team, that your international mobile employee can really do their job and develop the business for the good sake of your company. So we will, next slide, please Fabrice. We will present you here quickly a few new responsibilities or advice we want to share with you after this pandemic.
Just if I may, Laurent, if you want to ask question, so don't hesitate to click on ask a question on the right of your screen. So you just wait 2 seconds, and then you will have the possibility to ask all the questions you may have. Thank you, Laurent.
Thank you, Fabrice. Well, that's a comment for you, not for me, obviously. So we will, if you can just quickly show us, Fabrice, the five, yes, new social responsibility. I'm not going to go into detail now. There's a slide each after. But you will see that it touches subjects like communication, like benefits, like practical issues, and new tools that you should consider in the future to make sure, again, that you can attract people, you can offer them an international position in the future that is good for the employee, that is good for you, and that won't put you in a difficult situation in the future, because we have seen with Florence that now there is a lot at stake and you need to be extremely cautious in the future. So we will move to the first one, which is directly linked with the communication and the implementation of an emergency plan. It's really a question of making sure that people who are already abroad are totally supported by the company. And it's more of a question of attractiveness for you to make sure that in the future, the situation we have faced is not going to prevent you from sending people abroad. So you really need to focus on asking you all the good questions to make sure that, again, you will be able to attract people that would be then able to have an international assignment. So making sure that you've got everything in place to look after the employees, their families, so that they can continue their assignment. You need to think more about all the consequences of this crisis, and we will see that a bit later. This implied, for example, the local healthcare system. Florence mentioned that also earlier. We had a lot of questions from you. You have asked us to provide you information at the beginning of the crisis and on which hospital were accredited to receive can't. It has been fairly complex at the beginning, so there's a strong focus that we need to put on the mapping of the local healthcare system to make sure that indeed people are extremely comfortable and that they have all the information in case of such a pandemic happen again. We will see later also what we can offer in terms of telemedicine and mental health support. The second slide here regards the medical evacuation coverage. Again, it's also a lesson learned. We have seen that with some providers, pandemia was an exclusion. So there's a strong focus that needs to be put on studying really the condition of your contract so that there is no uncertainty about the coverage. Here, it's in the case of a COVID situation. I'm not talking about what I was calling the preventive evacuation, people who do worry staying in a country because they are not comfortable. But it's also something you should be considering, but it's not normally something that is taken into consideration by insurer. So here, again, it's a question of reassuring employees or their family and making sure also that you can be attractive for new assignees. Here on slide 15, I would like to spend a few more minutes on this one. We all know now that COVID has really affected all the people, but in your case, we're talking active people, but also people with comorbidities. It's true that before, there was already a focus being made on medical checkup, on making sure that you were sending people that were healthy. But with COVID, it's absolutely critical, we believe, that you really take into consideration the health of your employee and of the family before sending them abroad and before sending them in countries where we know that the capability of the national health system can be too low in case of a future pandemic. So it's really to avoid future problems, of course, protect the health of your employees, and make sure that you don't put yourself and your employee in a bad situation. So I would like to spend 2 minutes because we have developed a really nice tool. That's not the purpose today, but we are able to help you in this regard. We have built a fully digital solution where we will set up in our system all the parameters in terms of medical checkup, who is eligible, what is the pattern, pre-expat, every other year, every year, the employee only, the whole family. So all can be set up in the system, and it's a good way for you to make sure that those checkups are really done. And you will have also to our portal a report in real time that will give you clear visibility on who has done his checkup, what is the state of the checkup, who hasn't done it. So I would really encourage you, if you are interested, to come to us, and we can really help you on this subject that is really now strategic for you. Next slide, please. You have also all faced really practical problem during this crisis. So you were obliged to cope with problem you did not imagine before, of course. Problem related to quarantine, problems linked to family that were split, employee that could not come back to his home country because after that it was impossible for him to go back to the host country. The family was maybe stuck at the home country, so all those complex cases has really created a lot of hassles for you. So it's really important to have all the procedures in place and again, anticipate and make sure that you have a mapping on all the problems you can face in the future and the solution and the process you put in front of all that. It's also a question of cost, of course, also, because when nothing is planned, at the end of the day, it's risky and it's also expensive. So we will really encourage you to do this mapping, this analysis, and make sure again that you have everything in place in case of such a situation happening again. We discuss a lot with you the provision of digital telemedicine and mental health. We strongly believe now that it is in a way compulsory to offer that to your international mobile population. We have seen, of course, the use of such tools going skyrocketing. And we were very happy to have such a solution in place. And it's really key when people are afraid to visit hospitals, clinics, doctors, where all the medical system is totally saturated. It's absolutely key to be able to offer such a solution. Telemedicine has been developing a lot. A lot of specialist consultation can be done online, at least for a first opinion. Same thing, of course, with mental health. We've been working with our partner, Telmed, in that case, and it has been extremely useful for us to be able to offer those kind of support in several languages, because when we speak mental health, people are, of course, more at ease in their native language. So that's very important to make sure that you can provide such a solution to your employee. This will also, again, reassure them and also be necessary if you want to attract a new talent in the future. Thank you very much. So thank you, Florence. It's now 22:03, so we are on time, just a few minutes before, maybe. So more than happy to answer your question, as Fabrice said, you can use the chat. So we leave it to you, Fabrice.
So let's start with the first question. So have you noticed that your clients have taken pandemics into account in the way they organize the movements of their employees? I think it's a question for Florence.
But they stop often the movement for the employee. In fact, during the COVID, the principal issue is the immigration process. And independently, the decision for the company, for example, to organize the repatriation should, for we have a lot of cases, what it was not possible because the frontier closed totally with 1 day, and it's totally impossible to repatriate people. And we have another situation, or people refuse to go for to another country. And we have clearly this situation, and we continue to have this situation with the China people to refuse to go to the Europe. But clearly, the principal issue at first is the immigration situation. And after the, and if the people could be not repatriated to come back at home, often we organize, we have a lot of clients to organize the home office because they close the site and they organize to manage this crisis with home office or another solution. It depends. But clearly, home office is really very, very applicable during this crisis.
Okay, thank you. So another question. Well, what happens if one of my employees refuses to return to their home country? Let's say, for instance, an employee in Brazil.
Yeah.
Come back to France.
But it's necessary to prove this situation. If the employee refuses, it could be cover the employer, because if the employer decides and would like that the employee come back, it is possible to organize and to maintain the employee outside, abroad, but it depends if the employer it's okay or not. But if it is for the personal reason, notably if the family is in Brazil, for example, in this case, the employer should be organized a document signed by the employee to confirm the refusal for him to stay in Brazil, and to decide if it is possible or not to continue this this expatriation or this mobility in Brazil, because it's not a solution to close totally the door for the employer, for the risk employer, if the employee is sick, for example, or take a COVID, or it's a hospitalization, something, I don't know. But it could be a good point if you can prove that the decision is not the employer decision, but the employee decision. If the employer decide the mission is terminated, in this case, the refusal of the employee should be treated regarding the termination procedure from in application of French law.
Okay, thank you very much, Florence. So let's take another question. We talked a lot about the French regulation. Is this regulation, duty of care of the employer, also applies in every single country in the world?
Oh, no. It's for the French employer, yes, because this application, it's a mandatory article in the labor code, and it's a public order provision. That's why it's not possible to derogate by the employment contract or by the collective agreement. But clearly, the repatriation obligation, you should see that in the Austria or Singapore or European country. Health and safety, it's clearly the European obligation to be respected for all European countries. But after, we have a lot of countries without no obligation. That's why it's really a good point to organize this situation, and notably if we decide to organize a repatriation or redeployment of the employee in the home country or another place, it's a really, really a good recommendation to organize that by the contract and by the contract.
Okay, thank you. So a new question from Fernando. It was mentioned that once the expatriation is finished, if the employee doesn't accept the new position in France, this can be considered a dismissal without serious in real case. However, if the employer did respect the responsibility of offering a real job relevant to his previous role, there is no such a dismissal, right?
Normally, it's in France, when we decide to stop an mission and the termination of mission is correct, normally the French employer could be revendicate an abandonment of post. Because in fact, when the employer decides to terminate the mission, the employee have an obligation to take a new function in France or another place. And if you refuse totally this case, you can we have an abandonment of post. But please, it's necessary to document this situation because we take a risk that the dismissal motivation should be challenged by the employee and could be open the door to negotiation.
Okay, thank you for this clarification. So let's take another question from Marion. Regarding the health coverage, in case of a localization of an expatriate, should the future host entity inform the employee of the health coverage? Because in some countries, only the general systems applies and there is no mandatory complementary coverage, in bracket, no mutuel. Should they present the employee voluntary options that can be paid by the employee himself for mutuel?
But it depends, it is possible, but clearly please note that when you localize an employee from the French company to host country, it's necessary that this information should be indicated in the transfer agreement based in French law. Because it's not an obligation for the host company to describe, it's not perhaps an obligation to describe anything for the health coverage. That's why it is really important to organize the information from the French law standpoint. After, locally, yes, it is possible that you organize the payment of contribution or the complementary health coverage, for example, directly paid by the employee, or perhaps to pay the host company could be accept to pay the portion. It depends on the agreement with the employee. For example, when we have the local plus plus regarding the expatriate scheme, it is possible to organize this coverage during the 1 year, 2 years, 3 years, it depends the case. And it is possible for the non-employee to decide to organize a voluntary coverage scheme and to pay himself, or that to mandate the French company to pay directly if he decides to organize the voluntary French voluntary scheme. For example, the CFE is not an obligation, clearly. And we have localized people in Singapore, for example. He takes a job in Singapore and he could be take decide to pay the CFE for the family, for example, for him and family. And in this case, we have two situations. If we have no relationship with the home company in France, the payment is directly managed by the employee, or by moment, we have an organization that the French company is mandated by this employee to pay the French contribution, and the employee reimburses this contribution. It depends the case, depending the host country, because we have the host country where it's very difficult for the change, for the financial control to transfer money from to transfer the euro from the local account banking.
Okay, so don't hesitate to ask Florence or Laurent any other questions you may have. We have still a few minutes to go. So let's take another question from Barbara. So is the clause in the expatriation contract informing about maintained home social benefits, in brackets, pensions and others, enough in terms of duty of information obligations of French law? In that case, would the signature of the employee be considered as the written proof?
Yes, normally yes. But in fact, I am prudent now because regarding the retirement-based contribution, we have different court decision and current claim discussion with the court in France to discuss the level of this basis contribution. That's why I'm really prudent. Yes, normally by the signature, employee accept and agree regarding this case. If the description is correct, normally it could be not claim anything after, but by the past and currently I have two clients who have the discussion and they lost a lot of money before the court regarding the level of contribution paid by the company, by the French company with an expatriate the classic expatriate scheme to maintain voluntary scheme in France, to maintain the retirement pension plan Agirc-Arrco in France. But now the employee refuse and contest the level of remuneration to as a basis of this contribution. That's why I am prudent, because often the documentation is clear but not totally complete regarding the financial information.
Okay, thank you. So maybe now a question more maybe for Laurent. In practical terms, how does it work to implement a health checkup solution?
In fact, to be quick, I mean, we need to analyze your needs. This is what I commented earlier. Define together the population you want to consider. Is it only the employee? Is it the whole family? Do you want to do only checkup before expatriation? Do you want to do checkup during the course of expatriation? Every year, every other year. So we will define all the criteria. Normally with the support of also the medical doctor of the employer, if any. And then this is all set up in the system and it's quite straightforward. So it's more the analysis before that takes time and make sure that we are all in agreement. But it's something that is quite easy and quite quick to put in place. So it's really the main rules before, frequency and eligibility, that need to be defined.
Okay, so many thanks for this answer. So I don't think that we have a new questions. I don't know if you would like to sum it up, Laurent or Florence?
No, in that case, if there are no more questions, we personally, I don't know, Florence, if you want to add something, but I just want to thank you for your time. You've spent nearly 1 hour with us this afternoon. So thanks very much. Hope this was useful. And again, a replay will be done, and presentation will be sent to you. So thank you, and hope to see you soon. Bye-bye.
Thank you very much. Thank you.
And don't hesitate. So following the webinar, you will receive an emailing with a survey. In this survey, you will have the possibility to give us new ideas for future webinars to come. So don't hesitate to share with us what may be of interest for you. Many thanks for your participation.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you, Fabrice. Thank you, Florence.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you, bye.